Last week, 16 players fought for the final spot at the mid-set finale by competing in the Challenger Series number 4. By the end of the tournament, Kivix punched his ticket to the mid-set finale and did it in style. I'm here to show you 5 of the best moments from the Challenger Series number 4. Let's get started with the tournament winner himself showing off one of the most fun boards we've seen in tournament. At 3-5, we see Kivix take a spatula off of Carousel. While we don't see his board again for a little bit, the next time we do, it appears that spatula has multiplied, as Kivix is now sitting on 2 assassin spatulas and a forgotten emblem. With a crazy 6 assassin Draven critting every team's backline, Kivix styled his way into a top 4. Next up, Valet takes advantage of the reworked Kale to show how this unit can be played slightly differently than before. At stage 4-1, Valet opts to not roll, understanding that he has a great economy, 2 Nico's helps, and health to spare. By making a hodgepodge board of Redeemed and Legionnaires, Valet skips right to level 8 at 4-5 and rolls all of his gold to find an item carrier for his 80 items. He finds a Kale and immediately begins to build a board around it. With a 2-star AD Kale and a crazy frontline including both God Kings, Valet finds a very important first place finish in day 1. Now, Kivix isn't the only person who can style with an assassin spatula, as Pickled Onion showed us in day 2 how Lee Sin can be one of the scariest assassins possible. After hitting Lee Sin and Katarina 3, Pickle Onion's 6 assassin Lee Sin begins to blow up the enemy backline. Between the mix of Nocturne, Katarina, and Lee Sin, Pickled Onion finds himself a pretty comfortable victory in a very strong lobby. Moving on to number 2, we have Aqua showing us how positioning can make all the difference in a fight. Going up against Solas's Dawnbringers, Aqua discovers that if Karma can freely attack his backline, he won't be able to win. So, Aqua makes an incredibly brave decision. He decides to position his Zyra opposite of Solas's Karma, despite the fact that it means placing it in front of a Viego. Confident that his Zyra will cast before the Viego, he places the Zyra down and Zyra casts just in time to take out the Karma before the Viego gets his ultimate off. With the Karma out of the picture, Aqua cruises through the final fight and into a first. And finally, our top moment isn't really a single moment, but 8 of them. One for each of the unique compositions that Kivix played in his 11 games of the Challenger Series. While many players will play a few comps that they're most comfortable with, Kivix showed us that if you can play every comp, you'll never not hit. In the final game, Kivix took home first place with Skirmishers, being the only person to win with that comp on day 2 and locking in his spot at the mid-set finale. And those are your top 5 moments of the final Challenger Series. With all 32 spots being filled, we're now looking forward to the mid-set finale starting on July 15th. Be sure to stay up to date on all things competitive TFT by following Giant Slayer TV online and subscribing below.